sooner it's off my hands, the better. Here's your hide, as requested.
I worried you might never return. Quickly, let me see it. Oh, as supple as a maiden's cheek, yet as adamant as her virtue. This is everything I had hoped for, and more. Clearly, my trust in you was not misplaced. You must be a hunter of considerable talent to have bested the beast with nary a scratch. Join me as my honored partner. With my means and your might, we shall be as wealthy as the merchant kings of Zemeckis.
I don't plan on making a habit of this. I'm busy enough as it is.
Very well. Though I believe fate had a hand in our meeting, it would be unbecoming of me to beg. Do not allow me to keep you from being about your business. Here, for the hide. This is hide unlike any I've had the pleasure of handling. My clients will pay a fortune for the merest scrap. This is hide.
Welcome, travelers. We don't get many visitors here in Tabor.
Thank you. Cyril. How fares the search?
Well, Your Grace, my report shall be with you ere long.
Ah, yes. Yotei is otherwise engaged, at my behest.
And the duty of wardenship?
Fulfilled. For as you see, I've been reunited with my first shield.
I am Cyril, Knight of the Undying and bearer of the Burning Quill, charged with chronicling the mortal deeds of His Grace, Joshua Rosfield, Keeper of the Flame of the Phoenix, and rightful Archduke of Rosaria.
I entrusted Cyril here with overseeing the investigation into Ultima's origins. Findings from his brothers and sisters afield are delivered here to be collated and catalogued.
Just how many undying are there?
Not nearly enough, m'lady. Yet we are glad to give our all in service to the Phoenix. Such is, and has ever been, our creed.
I see.
You have your associates, I have mine. But you may now think of them as ours. That won't be a problem, will it?
The Phoenix is our sun, and we but the shadows that quicken in his radiance. It is from the darkness that we serve, both him and now you. Pray accept this token. For as long as you bear it, members of our order will reveal themselves unto you. If there is nothing further.
No. You are dismissed.
Your Grace.
To Canva, then.
We'll talk about this later.
Cyril seemed very, You certainly keep strange bedfellows, Joshua.
Ah, Lord Rosfield. I'm afraid I cannot stay to talk. I must leave to collect the reports of our spies in the field. Now that you wear the Phoenix down, our brothers and sisters will no doubt reveal themselves to you too. Farewell, my lord, and may the Firebird's flame burn ever in your heart. Ah, Lord Rosfield. I'm afraid I cannot stay to talk.
Are you sure this is the right way, brother?
Thank you.
Don't mess with the leader of the pack, eh, boy?
Were it not for the Undying's aid, I would be long dead. Grant them your trust, and they will repay you with their loyalty. Were it not for the Undying's aid, I would be long...
Canva's walls will not hold the Akashic Horde for long. We can only hope they hold it for long enough.
There's barely been a shipment in since the skies started falling.
A few more days without a visit, and we'll have to start eating the blankets.
We've sent Cursebreakers to Martha's Rest, Dalamil, and North.
Do you like being struck by thunderbolts from on high? Then don't let anything happen to them.
How may I help you today, Clive? Best of luck out there, Sid.
See the pair that got hauled into tires?
I'm getting too old for this.
The curse.
You know how I feel about this, but your brother's stubbornness knows no bounds. I'm starting to think it runs in the family.
Three cities under siege?
There are horrible beasts down that way. Ashen terrors who'll kill you as soon as look at you. Would that I had the strength to kill them first.
Smoke.
Has the city fallen?
Thank you.
free men are still holding their own, then.
Do we have any idea where Gav and the others might be?
There's a warehouse near the docks where we agreed to meet if there was any trouble. We should hurry. Sounds like thunder.
You're late. We're starting to think you'd stumbled off a cliff.
I seem to recall that was you, Gav.
Good to see you. Any trouble on the road?
Nothing we couldn't handle.
I knew you'd come.
Is that who I think it is?
Yes.
Allow me to introduce my brother, Joshua.
Clive's told me all about you. Or even listening most of the time. Name's Midadol, but everyone calls me Mid.
My lady.
Hey.
My boy.
Uncle Byron.
It's really you. I never thought I'd see the day.
So these Akashic are being controlled.
That's what it looked like. Empty eyes, eerie blue glow. No doubt they were turned, but silent as monks, every last one of them.
Your man here speaks true, Clive. We saw more than a few in the city. They moved in ranks with a purpose, and not of their own.
Ultima's doing.
Perhaps.
What of the city? The people?
Dead, mostly.
Mostly, but not all. A handful managed to lock themselves in their villas before the Horde arrived. Some in the merchants' district to the west, and a few others on the far bank.
If the Akashic stumble across either hiding place, a few bolted doors won't hold them for long. We need to find them. And quickly.
What do you propose?
We split into two parties. I will make for the merchants' district, while you look to those across the river. Mind keeping an eye on my brother?
Not at all. We find the villa and try the servants' entrance.
Understood.
And what of us?
Mid, is she fit to sail?
The ship? The Mithril engine could probably do with a few more tweaks.
Then you better work fast. Even if we do reach the survivors in time, they'll never make it to the hideaway on foot.
You leave that to me.
See that Mid doesn't get herself into trouble, would you?
Think I can manage that.
I'll keep him safe.
Looks like you stuck with me, Byron.
That's Lord Rossfield, you little guttersnipe!
Shall we, then?
And you keep Clive safe.
Be careful. both of you.
You too.
Alright, Torgal. Let's find those survivors. They don't stand a chance against those things.
Thank you.
was my takeaway. Thank you.